Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you guys doing? I've made a video about Ben Shapiro yesterday and he has responded. He's responded on Piers Morgan's uncensored show. So let's take a look at what he says and respond in kind.
We're not talking about Hamas. We're talking about children here. We're talking about women here. We're talking about elderly people. You make me sick. You make me sick.
Well, what's your response to that, Ben? I mean, that will be, I'm sure, a reaction you've heard from a lot of people. What do you feel about that?
I mean, my obvious response is, of course, I feel horrible for the people who are being held by Hamas in a state of tyranny for the past 15 years. Hamas was the elected government in Gaza in 2006. There hasn't been an election since then. All the people who are today ranting, as you heard Mohammed Hijab doing right there, I don't hear them talking about liberating Gaza from Hamas, which is the greatest threat to the way of life of Gazans on planet Earth. Again, I have nothing but sympathy for Hamas, for the people that Hamas is governing, or the people that Hamas is exploiting, really. I have nothing but sympathy for civilians there. Israel has to defend itself. I don't understand exactly what the expectation would be here. Is the expectation that because Hamas uses human shields, that Israel therefore has to go home and wait to have its people murdered again? Now, Israel tried it the way that Mohammed Hijab and others would like.
Now, you'll notice that what he said is that, of course, I feel horrible, he says. Of course, I feel horrible for what Hamas is doing for the last 15 years. So you see, the key question that I put forward, which Piers couldn't carry over properly and ask properly, by the way, which he asked all Palestinian representatives, do you condemn the attacks? Do you condemn the attacks? Which was my question to Ben Shapiro. Do you condemn the attacks? He couldn't, and he didn't, and he wouldn't answer that question. Why? Because everything must be scapegoated to Hamas. Everything must be scapegoated to Hamas. Even before Hamas was an entity, the terrorism narrative was still in force by the Israelis against the secular PLO. This cannot and it will not fly anymore. Secondly, my question to Piers Morgan is, why didn't you ask this man the same question that you ask all the Palestinian representatives? Do you condemn the attacks which disproportionately affect women and children? Why is it that the killing of Jewish men, women and children who are non-combatants must be labeled as terrorism, but that the killing of men, women and children who are in the Gaza Strip by the IDF forces, where there can be an alternative motion, and I'll tell you what that is in a second, is not condemned? What is that thing? Because I said I'll say it in a second. They've made it out as this is the only option. They said this is the only option. That's not actually logically the case. It's not logically the case that the only option to fight Hamas is to disproportionately affect civilians, women and children. What other options are there? Face-to-face confrontation with Hamas. Face-to-face confrontation with Hamas. Targeted attacks of them. You can attack them directly and you can have a fight with them. One-on-one. Face-to-face. Man-to-man. Woman-to-woman if you've got them in your IDF forces. Let them fight. Why do you have to kill 95% of the injured are civilians? More than that. Maybe 99% of the civilians, the people who are injured are civilians. Do not make this out to be the only option. We are not dumb. We're not stupid. We're not foolish. Do not equate Israel has a right to defend itself with Israel has a right to annihilate, yeah, a civilian population. And look what he says. He says, frankly, I don't believe, yeah, that the proportionate response to terrorism, I don't believe in a proportionate response to terrorism. I believe that the response to terrorism should be wildly disproportionate response. That doesn't mean targeting civilians. He's using his words very clearly, not targeting them, but implicating them, yes. Implicating the majority of them, yes, yeah. Are you telling me that, okay, it doesn't mean targeting them, but if you're going to do an action which is going to assure, yeah, beyond reasonable doubt, that the majority target is going to be civilians, that that's not, in a sense, targeting civilians? This is a wild contradiction. And I know that you know that. I know that you know that. I know Piers Morgan knows that. I know Ben Shapiro knows that. I know the Daily Wire knows that. I know the British public know that. I know the American public know that. And I want to say something. When he was answering the question, didn't you see in his face him stammering and staggering and stuttering? Imagine that person who looked defeated already. Imagine that person who, he wasn't even with me face to face. He wasn't even responding to me on a telelink. He wasn't even speaking to me on Zoom. And he looked like he shit himself. He looked like he had shit himself and soiled himself. Imagine him being probed, yeah, by the likes of someone like me. He would shit himself. I can tell you that for a fact. The man would shit himself, just like the IDF are shitting themselves from face-to-face confrontation. The only thing that they can do is press buttons in a fortified place. لا يقاتلونكم جميعا إلا في قرى محصنة أو من وراء جدر. They don't fight you all together, except in a fortified place or behind walls. That's what you're about. Low risk, high reward. You're cowards. And you all know that you're cowards. You all know that you're cowards. Just like Ben Shapiro was staggering and stammering and stuttering. And he couldn't even contain himself. And you can see the you can see the effects of the butterflies in his stomach. The diarrhea being created in his bowels. Because he couldn't face. He knows who I am. He's watching my videos. Piers Morgan's watching my videos. But they would never, on a fair one-to-one basis, come and discuss the matter with me. Do you think Piers Morgan, on fair grounds, would try and speak to me about an issue like this? Or Ben Shapiro, when they know what I'm going to come with? Absolutely not. Don't pretend you don't know who I am. Don't pretend that I'm too small of a fish for you to understand. Especially knowing that I've had two engagements with your biggest star, Jordan Peterson. Don't pretend anymore. You've been watching my videos. You know what I'm about. Your silence is deafening. And your cowardice is apparent. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
السلام عليكم. لا تنسوا الإعجاب بالفيديو والاشتراك في القناة تشجيعا لنا لنستمر بنشر المزيد إن شاء الله.